It's no secret that Australians are among the most well-travelled people in the world. More than half the Australian population now owns a passport. As a nation, we took more than 10 million trips overseas between 2016 and 2017. But it's a stark contrast to 4 decades ago, when arts tourism lecturer David Bierma began his career in the tourism industry. In those days, about 2 million Australians were travelling internationally, and it was also quite an expensive thing to do, Dr. Bierma recalls. Dr. Bierma says the cost of most airfares, both domestic and international, are now lower in real terms than they were in 1977. Are Australians transitioning away from the iconic coastal getaway and opting for an adventure abroad instead? According to Drive Bimon, in the 1950s and 1960s, a lot of Australian families went on beach holidays along the coast. We still see this a lot among family travellers today, he says. But because the cost of having a beach holiday in Bali, Fiji, Thailand, Malaysia or the Philippines is cheaper than having one 200 kilometres up the road from a capital city in Australia, many people are actually taking that option of having their holidays overseas. Drive Bimon's sentiments are reflected in recent statistics from the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade's Consular State of Play report. According to the report, in 2016 the most popular holiday destinations for Australians were New Zealand, Indonesia, including Bali, and the United States. The report also showed that over the past 5 years, the number of Australians taking overseas trips has grown by about 5% each year. By world standards, we are among the greatest of world travellers, Drive Bimon says. Flipping through the family photo album at her home in Blacktown, New South Wales, 69-year-old Veronica Webster is no stranger to holidays overseas, but it was always so. I did go on a holiday overseas until I was married, she says. Our first major trip was in 1997 when we went to England. We drove ourselves around and then went on a bus trip around Europe. We had a wonderful time. Mrs. Webster says people are more willing to travel nowadays, whereas when she grew up in the country town of Bury, it was most unusual. Air flight was as prevalent back then as it is today. You had to go by ship and it would take, if you were going overseas, 6 to 8 weeks. Whereas now you can get there in 24 hours, she says. The trip to the United Kingdom and Europe was her husband Leon Webster's first time travelling abroad too. As one of 9 kids, I could say we ever went on a family holiday with Mum and Dad. They were so busy trying to keep the house and food on the table for the kids, he says. But we did regularly visit relatives. But they were weekends, Easter and Christmas around the Christmas area. Despite the continuing rise in international travel, Jonathan Hutchinson, based in Wollongong, New South Wales, still enjoys holidaying on the coast. The 41-year-old travelled abroad extensively in his 20s. But since starting a young family, he has begun opting for holidays at the beach. However, the father of 3 says he can see the appeal of an overseas getaway for Australian families living in regional and rural areas.